Filling to capacity. The face value of a top ticket for tonight's game, $67.20. Outside, we're exchanging hands at three times the face value.
Hello again, everybody. I'm Al Michaels along with Ken Dryden. It should be a great night. I'm sure there are a lot of people in this building who do not know the difference between a blue line and a closed line. It's irrelevant. It doesn't matter because what we have at hand, the rarest of sporting events, an event that needs no buildup, no superfluous adjectives. In a political or nationalistic sense, I'm sure this game is being viewed with varying perspectives. But manifestly, it is a hockey game. The United States and the Soviet Union on a sheet of ice in Lake Placid, New York. Ken, some of your thoughts before the game.
Well, for the U.S. team, it's really discovery time. It's one thing to be young and promising, and it's quite another to be good. And in the next 2.5 hours, the U.S. players will go through perhaps the most difficult and demanding, yet exhilarating time of their lives. They will be playing against probably the best team in the world, a team that's far better than they are, a team that's dominated world hockey for the last 15 years.
In the crowd, Jim Craig's father, Donald Craig. It's been a difficult time for the Craig family with the passing of Jimmy's mom. One of her dreams was to have her son play on this team. So this has to be an emotional night for the two of them.
Too nervous down there.
The U.S. team, very young, average age, 21 years old. The Soviets, much more seasoned. Some of them have been playing together for the last 15 years.
Go ahead, boys. Go ahead, boys.
And this game is about to get underway.
All right, on three, boys.
One, two, three.
USA!
Jim Craig in goal for the United States. Vladislav Tripiak, considered the best goalie in the world, in the nets for the Soviet Union. The U.S. team in white skating up the center ice. The Soviet Union in red, all business.